Hey guys, Becky with Design Bundles here, and I'm super excited to bring you another Silhouette Cameo 4 tutorial today. I love my Cameo 4, and I love even more all the things that it can make. Today, we are talking about using the foil quill.
All right, guys, so in Silhouette Studio, the first thing I want to do is go ahead and update my page design area, okay, my page setup panel. I'm going to choose my machine. I'm using a Cameo. My cutting mat, I'm just going to use the 12 by 12 auto for the Cameo. And then my media size is going to be letter because I am going to make a cute little card. I love using the foil quill to add little embellishments, and it looks really, really great on black cardstock. So that's what we're going to use today. Now, the first thing that I want to do is I do want to create just a base for my card. This is going to be a very basic project, so we are going to just create a square card. And handmade cards, typically a handmade card maker will cut and score and fold their card by hand. So, you know, if you guys have the tools to take care of that, then by all means, you do not have to create your card base here in Silhouette Studio. But for those of us who maybe are not as experienced with card making, or we just want to do it quick and easy, this is the way that we're going to do it, okay? I'm going to start by creating a rectangle, and that rectangle is going to be 5.5 inches wide by 8.5 inches tall. And I'm going to center that to my page. And then I'm going to draw a line, just any line. And this, it needs to be a straight line, so I'm going to hold down my shift key. And I want to go side to side, but not completely. So my line ends up being just a little over 5.25 inches. Now I can go ahead and also use the center of the page to center that line. Now what I want to do, and I'll show you on the panel, you have a panel called Line Style. And you can select a scored line, that way it gives you a fold. And of course you can select what type of perforated line you want, whether small perforations, large perforations. Okay, I'm going to choose this one here. It is the third one down. Okay, and I can go ahead and group these together. Now, ta-da, you have made a handmade card. Congratulations. Now, what I want to do, first of all, is go ahead and tell you that we have a video on creating your own single line designs where we talk about how to, we touch on using single line fonts, and I show you the difference of what a single line is versus a regular font. But we also show you how to take a regular file and fill it in so that it will not be just an outline. And that's the type of file that we're looking for to use with our foil quill. So I will link that video for you down below. Now what I want to do, I actually, in the Ultimate Dollar Deals that unfortunately is already ended, but you guys need to make note of it because the Design Bundles Dollar Deals, you always have really, really awesome deals. And I happen to score a single line bundle. So I'm going to choose a design from that bundle so that we don't get caught up in the designing process because I've already showed you that, right? And I can just move forward with showing you how to use the actual foil quill. Because if you have experience with using sketch pens or experience using etching, anything like that, where those single lines make a difference, then you already know what I'm talking about. And if you don't, I'm going to reference you to that other video to watch first, okay? All right, hopefully you guys don't mind. Now, I'm going to go ahead and go to File and Merge. And I'm going to pull up that folder for my downloaded item, okay? So this one right here, Single Line Sentiments, and it will add it straight into my designing area. Now, obviously, this is a lot of different sentiments, so don't be overwhelmed, but all of these are set up to use specifically with the foil quill. All right, now I can pick any of these. And let's see, let's slide over so you can see them all. And I'm just going to ungroup. Okay, now this is literally a mix and match situation. So again, I can just pick any of these and use it for my card. All right, so once you get your design picked out, you know, I know it's not anything super exciting. I think it's really cute, and I'm going to center it all. That way it's centered on the card. All right, and I'm not going to group it together, even though it's very tempting. You know, what I can do is I can group these together. That'll make me feel a little better. And let me just go ahead and zoom in. I want you guys to see what makes up this design. All right, so you basically have a series of single lines, and then the font is actually filled in using a series of offset lines, okay? So you will learn more about that if you check out that video. Maybe not the offset lines, but you will learn more about how to fill in your designs and what it takes to do that. But for now, I'm going to click over to the send panel. All right, guys, when we get to the send panel, there are a few adjustments that we're going to have to make. Now, you can go ahead and select your material. We are using cardstock. Action, we are going to go ahead and switch to sketch. And then for the tool, we are just going to use, we're going to say a pen holder. All right, now one thing that we are going to do is we're going to select the outline of our card and choose no sketch. And the reason we're going to do that is because we're going to go ahead and load our foil quill first, allow the foil quill to add the design to the cardstock, and then we will come back and swap out our foil quill, put our blade back in the tool one, and then allow it to cut out the card for us, okay? So with that in mind, we are going to go ahead and make note of these settings. Make sure your settings match my settings, and I'm going to head over to the Cameo 4. And then basically after the sketch is done, after the foil quill is done, I will come back to the software and show you how to switch it over back to your blade. It's really not complicated, but just in case, if you guys need to know, I will walk through that with you, okay?
All right, guys, so let's go ahead and talk about the foil quill. Now, this is not your traditional packaging. I bought this as part of a kit, but it does have all of the pieces if you buy the three-piece kit, right? So we have three different tips. This is your fine tip. I'm sorry. This is your fine tip, your medium tip, and then your bold tip. All right. And you can look at those and tell they're not confusing. Today we are using the mint colored medium tip. So I'm going to put these away. And then you have a package of adapters. Now I've already pulled out adapter D. That is what we're using with the Cameo 4. But you will want to check out these other adapters if you're using a different machine or a prior model Cameo. Okay. And of course you have this little guy. Now what this does, because we will need to allow the tip of the foil quill to heat up. So we will actually slide this underneath while it is heating so that it protects our Cameo from the heat of the tip. Okay. I hope that makes sense. You'll see that in action. Then we have our foil, and this was the starter kit that I got. Rose gold, silver, and gold. And this is the, it's like washi tape. It's a foil quill tape, but in my opinion, it's just like washi tape. And that's all I need for now. Now, I do need to tell you that the foil quill does need a power source. And a lot of people were excited because there are USB ports on most Cameos. Now, it is not on the Cameo 4, but it was on the Cameo 3, and everybody was like, oh, awesome, just plug it in. That is not the case. You do need a power source for this. A lot of people will use a battery pack. And then, of course, if you don't have, by battery pack, I mean like a mobile phone charger, you know. Now, you can also grab one of these, all right, if you have an outlet nearby or an extension cord that you can use, which is what I'm using today. But you can buy those battery packs at a variety of different places. All right, so when I plug it in, we get the light, the magic light, right? And I am going to go ahead and connect my adapter. Now this screws on. You have threads on each side, and this is going to screw on. And I'm going to remove my blade. My blade will come second. So set that to the side. And I'm going to go ahead and insert my foil quill all the way down, just like you would a blade. Let's go ahead and slide this guy under there and then snap him into place. All right, so we do need to give this enough time to heat up. And you do have this little booklet here that comes with it if you ever need just a quick refresher, and you can find out that it will take 5 minutes. And then they do have the quick guide on which machine is which adapter. So just something to keep handy, keep it with your kit. And while this is heating up, let's go ahead and talk about what foil we are going to use, and we can go ahead and attach it to our cardstock. Now I have black cardstock here on just my regular cutting mat. This is my less sticky cutting mat, okay? And if you need to, you can consult your laptop on where to put your foil. And I'm gonna say, gosh, that's a hard decision. What color do we want, guys? I want the rose gold, but I'm such a hoarder. Rose gold it is. So you're just gonna carefully remove any tape that's on the outside holding it closed. Now this is fairly fragile. It's just like if you've used any type of textile foil, but it is different. You gotta remember that. It is different from textile foil. So grab a pair of scissors and your tape. Go ahead and get some tape started. And I'm gonna go ahead and clip some off. So I have two pieces, one and two. Now remember, I kinda went a little extra and I have part of my design up here and the rest of my design down here. So I can either stretch it to cover that area, or I can get brave and cut those pieces. All right, it's completely up to you, whichever way you wanna do it. I, for the simplicity of this project, am gonna go ahead and stretch. So I'm gonna add one to this corner, and you do want to pull this tight. You don't want this to be super loose. Okay, so I'm going to attach my tape to my foil, okay? And then, because I already have these secured, right, I can just pull this tight, okay? There we go. Now I'm still going to go back in and add some more tape, because this is a pretty large piece. I just want to make sure that I just get the edge of it though. I don't want this to be all in the middle of my foil, okay? But I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna pull it and make sure that it's tight. So if any part of it doesn't look right to you, or you don't feel like it's tight enough, you can loosen this back up and readjust, okay? This is not permanent solution. All right, so can you see that? It's pretty tight, right? All right, so after my 5 minutes are up, then what I will do is I will remove my heat guard here, that little piece of metal. Don't forget, you do have to remove that, absolutely. And then I will load this in and send it to Sketch from my Cameo. All right, so let's let that finish heating up, and then you guys will see the magic in action. All right, guys, so once you are done quilling, you're gonna want to peel up the side and go ahead and check and just make sure that everything looks okay. Whatever you do, do not eject your mat from your machine, all right? I should have told you that in the beginning. We are not going to unload our mat from the machine. The foil quill job looks fantastic. I'm gonna go ahead and peel this off. Now, before you ask, yes, I'm gonna save this big part in the middle here. Now, given a choice, if you can position your design lower down on the mat, you do end up with less complications that way, because you're not having to try to pry it underneath the bar. But guys, I mean, look how awesome that is. Well, you can't really see, but there we go. You can see it now. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna unplug this. I'm gonna go ahead and remove it from the machine. Now remember, that's gonna be hot for a little bit, so keep it someplace safe. Put my blade back in. It's already adjusted where I need it to go, which is a 3 for a ratchet blade. But you notice I did not unload it, all right? Remember that. So I'm going to go back over to the software and we will switch out and cut the outside of our card. Okay.
All right, guys. So our quilling is done. If that's what you call it. I think that's what I call it. I call it the quilling. And now I can come in here and I want to make sure that I switch my foil quill to no cut and switch my outline to cut. All right. Now I'm going to leave the material at cardstock. I'm going to make sure that the action is set to cut instead of sketch and make sure my tool is selected. All right. And then I will be able to, no cut. There we go. And now I will be able to hit send, and this is going to cut this out on my Cameo 4.
All right, so after your cut is successful, and you can test that too if you want, after that's successful, now you can unload the mat and check out your new project. All right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn this over because, let me tell you, and let's slide this out of the way a little. My mat is sticky, so it's going to try to curl my cardstock. I don't want that to happen, so I'm actually peeling the mat up from the cardstock instead of the other way around. And I'm keeping my hand really close. Now it looks like I had one piece. Oh, just my corner piece up there didn't want to turn loose. So there we go. So this is a simple and easy card. Now you might be asking me, Becky, what about writing inside? Yes, we will cut a little mat that'll go on the inside and glue it in place. But guys, I mean, how cute is that? And I do love the rose gold. Gosh, I love the rose gold. So, all right, I will take photos of the finished project for you. So guys, how did you feel about our foil quill card? Look, you can see it all the way from there, can't you? I really love working with this foil. Now, you gotta understand, I started off in paper crafting, although you can't hardly tell it now because I actually wasn't very good at it. But this is where we started, and I do really love it. Now, don't forget, I got the little embellishment on the back too. That was a really cute addition, and I'm glad that I did that. Now, I did add the mats to the inside, and I just wanna say how much that really added a lot of stability to my card. So definitely an extra step that I recommend. And it is a good friend of mine's birthday tomorrow, so this is really going to come into handy. Now, I personally, you know, just all the time in the world, would just make up a ton of these, and then I would have one for every birthday and every occasion. And I just don't know anybody, well, I don't know any crafty person who does not appreciate a nice handmade card. All right, anyway, enough about handmade cards. I'm gonna bore y'all to death, but thanks for coming by today, guys. I hope you enjoyed our project with a foil quill. It is a very, very neat tool, and I do enjoy using it from time to time. Now, if you have any questions or comments about the project that we did, or using the foil quill in general, or about your Cameo 4, please feel free to leave that in the comments. I really love to hear from you guys. And if there's anything else you want to see, if you have any video suggestions, I want to hear from you too, okay? All right, now make sure you do your thing. Like, subscribe, and share. I really appreciate it. It helps us to grow the channel and to keep bringing you all these awesome tutorials. So I'm going to wrap it up for now. But thanks again, guys. I appreciate it. And I'll see you next time.